Good morning. I'm returning to the mountain that I did my first ever attempt to making a little movie of. Arenig Fach. When I did it last time, I did a different route. It took me way out the back, picked up a few of the tops, and then came back to Arenig Fach at the end. And it was so tough. It was such a struggle. And when I look back at that video now, there's loads of things that are quite bad. And hopefully I've improved a little bit since then. So today, I'm out with my friend Paul. And we're coming up a different route. We're just going to go up Arenig Fach, down the back, and around the lake, in Arenig Fach, I think it is. And then back again. It's only a half day walk, hopefully. It's April, and I've not been in the hills since January due to some not great mountain forecast, and also because my back's been bad. So I've made use of that time by doing some work on Stan the van. He needed some new rear sills manufacturing and welding in place, so I maybe cut to a little bit of standalone work now and show you what I've been up to. And then you can join us back on the hill in the thick. So behind me, over there, is Flint Selling. I used to think that was just a beautiful lake, I used to drive past it. And it's only in recent times I fully understood the significance and the history of it. A little village there in 1960, Capel Selling, little Welsh-speaking community. Was turfed out of their homes, and the reservoir created for the people of Liverpool for drinking water. And as somebody from Liverpool, that makes me feel quite bad now. The bad thing about it was it didn't really involve the Welsh people in the decision at all. The Liverpool Corporation at the time agreed all through Westminster, so the people of Liverpool and London decided the fate of this little Welsh village. not really involving them at all, which is terrible. But if anything good came out of it, the way they were treated this far, the Welsh nationalism and that has ultimately led to the Welsh Assembly and the decisions affecting Welsh people being taken by Welsh people, which is just how it should be. Good grief, though, this is very much Arenig Fach territory when you're climbing up through deep heather. I'm hoping once we've gone across lightly we'll be able to pick up a path, well, as good a path as you get in this area, which isn't much of a path, which will take us over to the summit. Wow, what a beautiful day it is. Wow. Welcome to the top of Arenig Fach on Good Friday. And it is a very good Friday. What a beautiful day. Right, let's do a little panorama up here. Right, time to have a little sit down and whip out Daisy for a summit tour. And it's time for second breakfast.
I think I need some chocolate or something.
It sounds like a plan. Right, that's the top of Arenig Fach, and I enjoyed it a lot more than last time. Last time I came here in the on a baking hot day, and I started out of Flynn Selling, and I came from all the way over there, all the way across, and by the time I got up here I was absolutely dead. Oh, I'm dying. There's not a breath of air. But we're going to go down the way that I came up last time, which is a really steep, heathery path alongside the lake, or the Flynn. At the end here, there's no path at first, so we're just going to have to find our way over, and then we'll drop steeply down and check out the lake at the bottom. Hello, this is Flynn Arenig Fach, on the dramatic side of Arenig Fach. Absolutely beautiful. We're going to find somewhere here to have a sit and relax for a bit before we do the journey back to Stanlivan. We're going to go around the lake and then and back around the other side. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Right, we've just jumped over that fence and we're back on the track that we came up on. No longer covered in frost. Lovely and warm now, beautiful day. We circumnavigated Clyn Arenig Fach. Quite boggy around there, but it's still lovely. Get over most of it without too much trouble. And so now it's just a matter of retracing our steps back to Stanavan. So I hope you have enjoyed this little movie. I definitely would recommend coming this way and not doing Arenig Fach the way the Nuttalls book suggests, which is a real struggle over some really difficult boggy ground. One final thought is just to dedicate this walk to, well, this movie really, to the people who were forced out of their homes in Kapelkelen back in 1960 for the benefit of the people of Liverpool. I know the Liverpool City Council has formally apologised for that about 30 years too late. But apologies from me as a scout or two. Right, not far to go till we're back at the van.